Good evening and welcome to the World of Tanks Pro League with me, Paul Renard-Challon, and alongside me, of course, is the one and only Stephen Sneeneal for a final edition of the World of Tanks Pro League Season 1, our final day ever. Not ever, but it's the final day of Season 1. How you doing?
I'm good, and you?
Yeah, not bad.
It's nice and cool in here. I don't want to leave the room.
It's a lot cooler in here, actually. It's a very warm day here in Germany today. We've got two matches for you, as ever, on the World of Tanks Pro League this week in Europe. And the final two games of the regular season. They are the relegation battle. I guess we call them relegation playoffs, up and downs. You can call them what you like. But that's basically, it's one team from the Pro League against one team from either the A Series or the GoForce Series who've earned the right over the season to challenge for a place inside the World of Tanks Pro League. There are 12 teams in the league. Only two have been automatically relegated. Lucky Karaki and 1SPP Zavisha are already gone. They're going to be replaced by the champions from the A-Series and the champions for Go4 next season. But there's an extra two spots up for grab. There were an extra four up, but well, the first 2 days, MYM and Evil Panda Squad were just too strong.
Yeah, they didn't even give the other team much of a chance. OM tried, OM Injection. They put up a bit of a fight, but still wasn't enough. And the other game was a 3-0, quite dominating from MYM,
yes.
We have to say.
Tonight we start off with a Suba versus Wusa. So that's going to be fun for the commentators, a Suba, a Wusa. And then we'll follow that with Alpha Squad against Team Morewhat.de. Explain to us how these two teams have come about and how they've qualified.
Wusa came through the Go For What. Yep. They finished on second place. So, what was it, second?
Could be third.
They finished third, and it's a German team. I have to be honest, I haven't heard much about them. They are the former, they used to be called Kuvadis. So they're a strong team, especially in the clan war scene. But in esports, they still have to make a name for themselves. Hmm. And on the other side, we have more WOT. They are kind of, it's kind of a semi-professional team because more WOT is actually a community page.
Yep.
And they sign their own team and they're committing only to World of Tanks, their community page, and putting a lot of effort in there, a lot of money, of their own money. So it's a really nice project for them, and they put in a lot of effort in there. I see good future for them. And they're also one of our casters for our German coverage as well. So
yeah. I mean, out of the two games tonight, do you think that more have an easier, let's not kid ourselves. These aren't easy jobs against regular World of Tanks Pro League teams. They've got a massive experience from the previous year that they've been involved. But with Alpha finishing third from bottom and Team More for what probably being the stronger of the two teams that we're going to see tonight, do you think they stand the best chance of getting into the World of Tanks Pro League? Or do you think that it's just probably a step too far tonight for both these teams?
I think it's going to be hard. I would have seen OM and Seven Sins. I would have seen them have a better chance.
Yep.
So if it would have been exactly over around that, OM and Seven Sins would play against Alpha and Isuba, we would have quite close fights. Maybe Isuba and Alpha would still be a bit better, but the skill level would be closer. Mm. I don't want to be mean or something, but I think Wusa and More WOT are, out of all four teams, probably not the strongest out of all of them. But still, they're not there for nothing. They put up a good fight, and they definitely... Well, they managed to qualify for the relegation, so they've definitely done a good job getting there so far. And if they just keep it up, and maybe a little bit of luck, and just a good portion of teamwork, they should have a good chance as well.
All right, cool. Well, we'll find out whether these teams have got what it takes. Oh, there's the pun. Early on. You didn't get that? You want me to do it again?
Yeah, do it again.
Let's see if they've got what it takes.
I got that one now.
Good, okay, good.
What's up?
What's up, everyone? let's see if they have got what it takes to get into the World of Tanks Pro League. I'm seeing that...
We have the invite.
We do have the invites, which is good news. We also have this oddity of tournament accounts again. I thought you were going to fix that.
No, the server restart still...
Bad guy, Stephen Neal.
I can't restart the World of Tanks servers. I was planning to go wherever the servers are, I think at Frankfurt, and just like press the restart button. But
right.
I think that, like, the community of a couple hundred thousand people playing at the time wouldn't have been that happy with me. So I thought... We'll just pull it off this way then.
Okay. Do we have... Oh, hold on. What are they doing?
Then we'll go to the garage.
Oh, they're all going to the garage. Yeah. That's fine. Yeah, I was just like, hang on a minute. Are they leaving? So we're not far away from the tank picks for this first game of this evening. It will be a Suba versus Wusa. And unfortunately, we won't have the Wusa team names on the screen. That's the reason behind that is that they're playing on tournament accounts, which have kindly been provided by Wargaming. Unfortunately, I didn't have time to set them up, and therefore you don't see their names, just the tournament numbers, which is a bit of a shame. So we'll do our best to obviously let you know what's going on with the two teams. Super have had their accounts for weeks, of course, so they're absolutely fine.
We did good last week, though.
I think we did okay. Yeah, I mean, it's not ideal, far from ideal. I guess while they're... they're ready for tank picks, by the looks of things. Yeah, so let's drop you into the tank picks, and we'll go through those. I also want to talk to you a little bit tonight about DreamHack, because it's only just around the corner now.
We can do that.
And when we've been talking about it for what seems like months, weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks, and it's literally like a week away.
It is.
I mean...
And it doesn't feel like it.
No. I don't know where the time's gone this year. Like, I mean, how the hell are we already in June? It's beyond me, but we are going to kick this one off. A relegation battle, then. The winner takes all. So let me explain the rules. Best of five, first one to three. And the winner gets a place in the World of Tanks Pro League. Now, that's as simple as it can get. At the moment, that place is held by Asuba. They finished fourth from bottom in the regular season. Hence, they're in this relegation battle. And if they lose to Wusa, Wusa will replace them in the World of Tanks Pro League by way of a promotion. So, big game for the underdogs, but big game for Asuba because... they're one of the well-funded and well-supported teams in the league. One of the supported professional teams. Asuba have been around for a long time, very good clan, and supporters across many, many games. And great to see Dignitas joining in, of course, for next season. They'll actually be Dignitas at the DreamHack Finals, which is great. They've, if you haven't already heard, and you blew and well should do, they took over Synergy. So Synergy finished second in the season behind Virtus Pro and just ahead of Mouse Sports. And they're already in the semi-finals, waiting at DreamHack for the other four teams to come through. I guess you could say that Dignitas are one of the favourites for the tournament.
Dignitas versus Pro?
Yeah, I mean, they have to be because of the way they've done through the regular season.
Well, versus Pro, if anything but first, will be a disappointment
absolutely.
For them, I think.
I think it would be, yeah. I mean, 21 wins in a row in the regular season would be odd if they then end up getting beaten on the LAN finals.
It would be.
Yeah, but stranger things have happened. We've seen it before in other games. So, anyway, back to this game. First two picks are in, 1390 and a T69 from Asuba. That's been followed up by two 1390s by Wusa. And we've since had 2.5 minutes since the last pick.
So I was just getting all the casters arranged there. Yeah. Arranged, so
and Asuba now pick up a T2 and a T69. So there's two 69s in the lineup so far. And Wusa, I don't think they've kind of figured it out just yet because they're new to this, but they've picked two 1390s, but in their lineup they've got a 5100 and a T1. Yeah, that's not going to work.
So the next pick from Wusa was two 50-2s. Makes it a 1390 and a 2 1390s and two 50-2s.
Yeah, which we've seen plenty of times this season. It's Prokhorovka, by the way, for map one. It's the most open of the maps in the map pool, and often lends itself quite nicely to having a couple of T-52s who can be a bit of a nuisance in the middle because they're difficult to hit and very quick. But we've got the GW Panther coming out for Asuba, and again, not that unusual. They've also attached a T-52 to it. But our new boys, Wusa, have gone for the Tier 7 Lorraine for their artillery and paired that with a T1.
Looks like Wusa's going for a really strong but still standard lineup. I remember Spale playing it last, and they didn't really got the T50-2s just speeding through there, doing all this action in the middle, what actually drew all attention towards them, and the other teams, teammates can just kill the tanks then. So it's a really strong lineup, even though they'll probably be rolling up with one Tier 8 tank less, if I have it right in mind, the way the lineup ends. So it's going to be a tough one, but on the other side, Itsuba's actually going for double T50-2 as well.
Yes, they are.
Just attacking a T2 line instead of a T1.
And a 1390 added to the Wusa lineup. So we'll just wait for them to confirm all of their different tanks. But I believe that's three 1390s in the lineup for Wusa.
Yep.
The Lorraine, two T52s and a T1. And on the other side, Asuba with the GW Panther, much lower. Well, not much lower. It's Tier 6 right now. Is that moving to Tier 7, by the way?
Which one?
The Panther.
And Lorraine is moving to Tier 8.
Yeah. And we've got a T69 times 2, a 1390, 250-2s, and a T2 light in the lineup for Asuba. So a bit more of a standard lineup from them. They're both fairly standard, actually. And we've seen both of these lineups used quite a long time.
There's some small differences in the lineup. So first of all, we have on the one side full 1390 action from Wusa. On the other side, we have two T69s and one 1390. They are what side of T69s are a bit better because of their shorter reload. So they only have four shots on the shells, but if you move it right, you shoot these four shells, try to dodge the AMX 1300 shells, and they have to reload 45 seconds, while you only have to reload 25 seconds. So you can get, in a small time frame, you can get 8 shells in total, while the AMX 1390s can only get 6 shells. So I think the T69 is a better choice there. The artillery is interesting as well. Isuba's going for the small artillery, so 1 tier point less. That gives them another tier point to put on the tier 1 and make the tier 1 even more powerful by taking the T2 light then. So that's the only difference in the lineup. And yeah, we'll have to see which one is better. I think overall it's going to come down to the T50-2 skills and the artillery skills.
Okay. Two teams look like they're ready. Voodoo's getting a little upset with the span that's in there. It seems like the Woosa guys are enjoying themselves in the chat. They've already pointed out that they don't want me on their team to view them due to the red eye curse.
Yeah.
The red eye curse is not a thing, okay? It's a travel curse. Sure, yeah, there's definitely a red eye travel curse. We're aware of that one. No one travels with me anymore.
Oh, definitely.
But the only curse this season has been with Spale, and we broke that several weeks ago. And it is not a proper curse anymore, people. What is a curse is the fact that we start on Prokhorovka. This is your first map.
So Prokhorovka, probably one of the fastest maps out of all of them. If you play the normal way, so not like going over the right-hand side and then start camping and then have a complete draw
Wait,
situation.
Are you saying that going over by the lake and camping is not normal?
Well, usually isn't that? Well, for some teams it might be normal, for some defensive teams out there. But, so yeah, it's the most open map, and usually we have the fastest games on this. And well, seeing these lineups, both teams with two T50-2s, we're definitely going to see a lot of action from the beginning onward here. So, and saying this, we can see straight away from Isuba, both heading towards the middle, and on the other side from Wooza, have the same. So we're going to see small engagement coming up in the middle pretty soon.
Yep, Mirage and Twix are both making their way towards the middle, as you'd expect in those T-52s. And they meet two of their opponents right in the middle as well. And they've split across the line, four across. And, oh, a little bit of damage. Tracks come off there of Mirage, who's already been attacked here, and they've decided to then focus in on him, and he'll get blown up. And that'll be the first one down already, and a Subaru are the first ones to lose a man. Twixo's not in the healthiest of positions right now either. He's had one shell landed on, although Woosa look like they're going to lose one here. That T-52 is going to go down, and we have a 1-for-1 at the start of the game. So fairly good start from Woosa, but a super equal to it.
That's right. Now Twix is trying to find the artillery. He went all over down to the bottom, to the top right of the map. Just went past the artillery, and he did spot him as well. So it's now down to the GW Panther to actually connect the shell and take him down. But in the meantime, we do see a kill in the middle. Another one from... Oh, see quite a lot of kills going in the middle.
It's a graveyard of trains right now. Check this out. Look. Oh, my goodness. Quick, call a parliament, because they've all gone down. Three of them went down very quickly indeed. And we've now got a 4-2 scoreline in favour of Isuba. And they have, obviously, their GW Panther still alive. Two tier 8s. The T-50-2 and their T2 light still alive here, and they're against the Lorraine artillery and two tier 8 tanks only left for Woosa. This could be a quick win.
Could be, but it's still nothing lost yet. There's the two AMX 1390s left on the side of Woosa, both pretty healthy as well. And then back to the artillery, they can do a lot of damage. Just have to let the light tanks do the spotting and then the artillery do the damage here. On the other side, it's two tier 8s versus two tier 8s. The only difference is the T-50-2, what can be really, really annoying against the French AMX 1390.
Yeah, Twixo right now has decided he's going to go and try and flush him out. He's the perfect tank to do it as well.
Yeah,
T-50-2 just checking out by the crossover. It's sort of the mid-map, we call that the E-line.
He's just trying to try and circle around the middle, hoping to get one or two spots on the AMX 1390s. He knows that one is on the right-hand side of the tracks, and he also knows there's artillery down there, and they will probably will relocate over to the right-hand side of the map just because they lost the left-hand side. On the other side, what Isuba has is the T2 light, and that's probably going to be one of the most important tanks in this game now, because they can just pin down the 1390s from Wooza on the right-hand side of the map, and just let the T2 light do the capping then. And if they do want to decap, fair enough, then it will spot the tanks coming, and the artillery and the tier 8 tanks will just do their job and kill them.
Yeah, a lot more flexibility in the Isuba lineup that remains. Those five tanks. Stephen said, they've got some speed in there as well. They're pinging A1 right now. I think they may think that the Lorraine has disappeared back to A1, which is pretty much where Stephen just said it might go.
The whole Wooza team, two out of the three are at the top right of the map now on this small island, so with the river there to slow down tanks, we might want to push them and spot them. And 130-90 just on the hill on the right-hand side. So I think they just want to get a really defensive position. Actually, this positioning is more than really defensive because the 1390, you should be in front of the artillery, is even further behind, and the artillery is somewhere at the front looking towards the cap circle. It's getting quite slow at the moment, but I don't think it's going to endure just because of the fact that there's a T2 light and a 50-2 in there. T2 light will just cap. The 50-2 will spot on the 6th line, and they're both the GW Panther, the 1390 and the T69 just going to be in a position where they can just shoot anything that comes over the middle and over the A6 section or B6 section off the track.
I just want to give a little bit of airtime while we can to Marcus. In that GW Panther. We don't see it a huge amount of times just because the action and the battle is generally out in the field, and it's tricky to spot these artillery shots flying over the map. But he is and has been on the move. Look at him right now. He's in A1 on the minimap. Look, just here. And that's a long way from back here at home. Yeah. They've left the 1390 down here. The 50-2 is pushing along the railway line, and the 69 is going to back up that GW Panther, the T2 light, just on the edge of the cap circle right now as well. And as you can see, Twixo moving up behind him. There he is. Voodoo's in that tier 8 tank, and the 1390 as well is covering back at home base, just because they want to cover any cap attempt by Wooza. The T52 right now still hunting at the end of the train line. He's literally gone the entire length of the train line and hasn't spotted a single one.
He's getting hungry there, trying to find out what's going on. And he peaked up really slow.
Well, you see, they can afford to lose him. Well, not lose him, but they can afford for him to go in and find where they are because they haven't lost the game. And there's 7 tier points between the two teams right now. So, well, is that right? Hang on a minute. 8, 16, add 7 is 23.
6 difference.
8, 16, 22, 27, 29.
The 6 difference, should be.
Yeah. So we're not enough anyway for the team to win. So
they can lose a tank. I think the 50-2 was hoping to proxy spot anything along the tracks. Didn't do so. So peaked over the top of the tracks. Wasn't spotted either. So I would have expected him to actually drop down and start doing a scout on the other side. But it looks like he wants to come from a different angle. And there we go. He knows right all the way down south. I'm definitely going to be safe. So he's going to probably take this route. And there we see it dropping down the right hand side. And now the scouting starts on this side of the map. And he will slowly find out what's going on there.
Yeah, it's a long way back down there, but he's in that 50-2, so it won't take him a huge amount of time. Just about 45 seconds to go to the other end, possibly a minute. Super leading 4-2 right now in map number 1 on Prokhorovka in the relegation playoff with Wooza. And Twixo taking this one a little bit more cagey because he knows very well that they are not on the other two-thirds of the side of the map. They are in here somewhere. And he knows it.
Yeah, he's spotted
there
now.
There it is. So he has managed to spot one. And unfortunately for him, though, he's managed to get away with the first shot. Here come the shells down. And Voodoo's is now going to make his way across in that 1390 as well. The shells from this man onto Twixo have not been good, though. Although there was a little bit of minor damage. He's done his job now, though. And here comes artillery shots right on top of them as well. They need this one. And that'll be game over for Asuba. But I think they've lost them right now.
Now, this is where the T2 light comes into play now. Because even though it's a small tank, it seems to be useless in this kind of lineup now, with the remaining part of the game. But he's the most important tank because he can die. You don't need him for any action, but he can put on the pressure in the cap circle and stay safe enough.
Yeah, that's what he's doing right now. They're going to take pot shots at him via artillery. And they've now spotted one as well in one of the tier 8 tanks. And they are going to try and come back for this. So they are baiting him out. There's still a minute remaining for him to full cap, so plenty of time for Wooza to come into the cap circle. But as soon as they come out now, they're going to be surrounded. Los Cocos is over there. Twixo is over there. And so too is Voodoo's, who's taking a little bit of damage right now. He's going to have to be careful here. He's down a 527. Los Cocos down a 494 now as well. So they're really struggling, these two. And Twixo is not going to be a huge amount of help. But here comes Voodoos. He gets one. They're not going to get the other one. The Los Cocos does go down. The GG is called already, though, from Woosa, as they do lose a tier 8 tank. But it's not done just yet.
Now the last shot from Voodoos just came towards the tracks, hit the tracks, but didn't do no damage because the tracks, they have this, the ability to absorb damage here. So looking for the Amex 1390 from Wooza, but still the cap is going on. There's 10 seconds left and I can't see any way for them to manage to decap this.
Well, they are going to try it. They're heading one towards the cap circle now, but they're not going to have time to get there. They are saying GG. I thought Vostek was going to go out of the circle then. It hits 100. Enemy base captured. Isuba wins on Prokhorovka. And it's via a full cap. We don't see many of them.
We don't see many at
but
all.
We did see one on Monday in the relegation battles as well.
And we saw one on last match day as well. The final map, what decided everything.
Yeah, three full caps in three match days we've had now. And I think on my scoreboard, there were six in the entire season of what we televised. So seems to be a bit more usual these days. Good play by Asuba, though, to flush them out, because they didn't go into the cap circle early. They waited. They were patient.
Yeah.
And they waited until they flushed out a couple of men and then put the pressure on. It was like a double-pronged attack. We'll attack with our firepower and we'll attack with our strategy.
Yeah, it was really nice that you don't want to overextend that much. So slowly, step by step, find out what's going on, where the teams are. And then they've done really nice. Before they started the capping, they positioned their 1390s on the right-hand side of the map. Because they first set the T50-2 to find out where the tanks are. He wasn't spotted, so they're right, they knew we can send out other tanks there. Yep. Put them in position, and then start the capping. That baited out the tanks. They left their cover, and as soon as they came close enough to the AMX 1390s from and the T69 from Isuba, they just all of a sudden shot out their cover and started doing the damage. And that the first shot, and that's really important in any kind of engagement to have the first shot. So a really nice tactic and good execution there. So let's look.
Interesting. I'm not sure what Voodoos is on about there.
I don't know either. But
I didn't see anything. What?
I don't know what they're saying, but we can just carry on.
Yeah. Tank picks.
All right, next map is going to be Himmelsdorf. So we are going to see a full lineup of heavy tanks, or maybe one medium tank mixing with a T69. So let's see what happens now.
Interesting. Yes, there was a little bit of conversation. I don't want to repeat it because it's kind of private, but it was an interesting conversation between Voodoos and the Woosa guys. I was trying to figure out what he was talking about, because I couldn't figure it out, but okay. Hopefully it's not a problem. And we will get underway in the tank pick, so let's drop you into that for map number two. It will be on Himmelsdorf, as Stephen rightly said. Our favourite city map of the season, I have to say. It's seen a lot of message changes through the season with both the tank picks and the strategies. It's been excellent to see.
Well, it's getting weird at the moment.
Yeah.
So we're trying to solve the problem. What's going on between these two teams? And we can carry on playing this game. So first map was already Prokhorovka, finishing 1-0. So second map will be Himmelsdorf as soon as we get this started. But it seems to be some kind of issue between both teams, but we are onto it. All right, so the tank picking has started. We got two ice freeze from Wooza.
Yeah, they're going to kick off with two ice threes on Himmelsdorf. Let's see what a Suba follow up with. And we didn't do predictions, but I think it's safe to say this is going to be 3-0.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be mean to Woosa, but right now their attitude and their whole approach to this game seems wrong to me.
It
so
does.
I don't think this is going to be anything other than a 3-0.
Well, Isuba, we don't want to take away credit from Isuba. So Isuba is a strong team, and they definitely can. Well, even if Wooza would play with a different attitude, they still probably will win quite convincingly. But the way this thing is going at the moment, it looks like it's not even going to be a big problem at all for them. So,
oh my goodness. Okay, so two T1s for Asuba, two 5100s from Wusa, and then they decided to pick again. Oh my goodness. And then Voodoo's now have got IS3 and 5100. Wusa go back to two times T1s. Asuba then pick an IS3 and a T69. And the last pick of the round comes in from Wusa for T69. So we'll wait until they've completed all their lineups and then go through them one by one just to give you the overview of what they've picked out. But I make that double 5100, double T1s, double T69, double IS3 and a T69 in their lineup. On the other side, Asuba are going to finish off with a 5100. So they have double IS3, double 5100, a 69, and two T1s. It is not quite a mirror match, I don't believe. But it's not far off. Did they go for double 69s or did they go for double IS3?
Wusa went for double IS3s.
That is going to be a mirror then. Because Los Cocos is going to add an IS3 to his.
He was just in the IS3. Looks like he's just going to refill his shells and equipment.
Yeah.
So, just have to wait for him to join. Actually. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I like the last sentence from Voodoo's. Is this something good for me or something bad?
Yeah.
Does it mean like I'm the mean guy you don't want to be messing with or something? Or is it because I'm... I don't know, but I like it. All right, so next game is going to kick off. We are here on Himmelsdorf. Wusa against Asuba.
I haven't seen that level of rudeness from players in some time, I have to say, in any game.
No.
And that's pretty disgraceful.
It's a shame for the league.
Not a shame for the league because they're not going to be in it.
Yeah, but it's a shame for
bloody good riddance, thankfully.
It's a shame for the teams who actually really tried hard,
yes.
Fought hard for weeks or months to actually get this far to relegate,
yeah.
Or to qualify for the Pro League, and then a team that seems to like not deserve it at all.
I don't doubt that they deserve to be here and
well, skill-wise, yeah. Attitude-wise.
Skill-wise, absolutely. But the attitude that they're displaying in the in the chat tonight is horrible. It's absolutely awful. I've not seen that for a long time. And, they're not going to be in the Pro League next season anyway, so...
I don't think it's going to happen. It's looking quite convincing for Asuba in the first map. They knew exactly what they're doing. Really strong tactics, and I can't see them losing this map either.
So Asuba have kicked off on Himmelsdorf by putting six tanks out to the left very early on, and just a single T1 going to go up on the hill. That's old school stuff, that is. Meanwhile, we've got a T1 rushing in and an IS3, both coming in very quickly. They're going to lose a bit of damage here. Yeah. And they're going to try and place themselves along the F line here. They were spotted, but now disappeared. So, interesting. What are Wusa going to come up with here?
Looks like Wusa doesn't want to lose any time at all. Two IS3s, T69 and a T1 are heading all the way down towards the base. First shots have been exchanged here onto the T69, and there's also a flank coming from the left-hand side with two 5100s.
Wow, so big, big, quick push here from Wusa. We've got those two Tier 8s led by a Tier 1 down the main street in towards the cap circle. They are literally going to reach the cap circle in less than 1 minute and 20 seconds. Here we go then. Exchange of fire inside that area already. They've not got in the cap circle just yet. That T1 managed to make its way all the way around to the side of the church and will now go into the cap circle. So game on already. And time for Asuba to do some super defending.
That's right. It's going to be really hard to kill this T1. So that's kill the Tier 8 tanks as fast as possible. They don't want to be delayed too long because then there's no way to take it down a T1. We do see one. Another T1 actually heading towards the cap circle as well, over the hillside, so it's going to be soon two who are going to put on the pressure in the cap circle, yeah.
Voodoo's just checking down the left-hand side. He didn't really need to either because there isn't anyone here, but he's going to come all the way back round. They have decapped this first one, but it will continue straight away. It's now going to be a T1 versus a T1 battle as we now see a battle starting out in the middle here. Twixo might go down in the bottom of this. Two have already dropped. Make that three now have dropped from Asuba. They're in a bit of trouble here. And Woosa somehow have got themselves a 3-1 lead after a cheeky and audacious push, wasting no time whatsoever to go into the cap circle early on.
That's right, but one tank's really low here from Woosa, 46 HP. The IS-3 is not that healthy either, only just under 500 HP as well. So it's going to be a tricky one. The other two tanks as well, 150, 100 down to 306, and the T69, 824. So the only healthy tank left in the lineup from Woosa at the moment, but Woosa has got this tank in the cap circle. Even two now, sorry. 10 seconds left.
Yeah, they've got three in there. They've only got 15 seconds here, Asuba. They've got to do something about this. Two inside the cap circle. Here comes Mirage, and he's got to do something about it. Voodoo's is in there as well. And here comes Woosa spinning around. That turret's not going to spin quick enough, and he's going to go down after the second shot. And Asuba ripped through Woosa. Four kills in a row. They now have one final man remaining. And this will be GG as far as Asuba are concerned. They will win map number two.
Yeah, it was looking quite strong for Woosa there. The really nice push over left hand side, but then, well, they killed a lot of tanks, but the amount of damage they take from while killing these tanks was so high that the remaining tanks from Asuba actually just had no problem at all to just finish off the final shells. One tank was a one shot, the other tank was with a bit of luck, a one shot as well. If not, it's only two shots needed. The both T1s were killed pretty fast on T69, so overall, really nice. And again, Isuba staying calm, not committing too much, not overextending, yep. Just realizing what's going on and waiting for the perfect moment to start the push.
Indeed. Also, not rising to the bait that they were given before the game started, either, with all the grief going on, which is important. There are just three main tanks involved there. Two for Voodoo's, two for Mirage, 2,414 damage from him, and three for 1,936. For Los Cocos. One of the IS-3s, though, on Woosa, kudos to him, one kill for 1,774 damage. So barely a fight, really, in the end, but a straightforward win in map two for Asuba. Let's see if they can grab a third in a row. And Abbey will be our third map, and we're already underway in the tank pick, so we'll drop you into map three. T2, 1390 for Asuba. Two times 1390s for Woosa. And then a T69 Storm Panzer 2 set up for Asuba in round two of the picks. I wonder if they're going double artillery here. Be unlikely, I suppose, but...
Well, usually if they go for a single small artillery, usually it's only the Bison then, because they get it for a T71. Yeah. So taking a tier 3 artillery, it could be double artillery. We'll have to see.
I don't think Woosa are going to even pick artillery right now. They've gone for 269s. 2 1390s.
So a strong, fast lineup there.
Yeah.
I'd have to say, looking at the chat, what I was writing, and if you see another fast push, with this lineup, no messing around, just fast push, I actually see this one winning. Because that's one thing I was always missing in many pro games, that this fast push right at the beginning.
Oh, using hold on. Alert, 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 alert. The coffee is out again. Well, the Chaffee, as it's supposed to be called. The Chaffee and the 1390 for Voodoo's Asuba team, where we haven't seen the Chaffee for, like, 10 match days. Match day 12 was the last time we saw a Chaffee.
We talked money about it, like...
We did.
And I was like saying, yeah, finally, finally it's right.
Hold on. We've also got an E100 out.
Yeah, he's a trolling, because it did anything.
I was just seeing whether we could actually get that one in on air or not.
So they're going to go. That tank, I would see Asuba winning. No offense to Asuba, but.
So they're going to have a T1. Of course, can't have the E100. And the Lorraine artillery for Woosa. So they are going to go artillery, and it's going to be full on tier 7 artillery via the Lorraine 155. And just the last pick remaining. Oh, no, that was the last pick. Of course, they had a 1390 in there, didn't they? So yeah. Three 1390s, a Chaffee, Stormhands are two, and a T2 Light. We've seen a number of mixes, actually, on Abbey, haven't we? We've seen some Tier 7 tanks.
Yeah,
we've seen T71 on it. We've seen a 32 on it.
T50-2 had its moment.
50-2's had a couple of times out and a bit of a run on it as well. And now the Chaffee gets a run.
I don't understand that, to be honest.
No, nor me.
I still don't agree on the Chaffee. I still see the 50-2 as a stronger choice.
It's a vastly superior tank all round.
Yeah. Chaffee has a better gun, but the lack of speed and maneuverability is. Yeah. I'd rather go for the 50 dash.
Yeah, I mean, you haven't got the armor and you haven't got the health, so.
Both don't, so what's the point then?
Yeah. I mean, if you get hit by a good shell, you're dead. If you get hit by two shells, you're definitely gone.
And both tanks, so then rather go for the speed and.
Exactly.
Because overall, you can still catch up with the damage then, just because you can dodge more, shoot longer.
So we're ready for map number three. It's going to be on Abbey, the wonderful Italian village.
Yes, finally! Life makes sense again.
Oh, see, I was trying to troll you, thinking that what you would say is you'd go, yes, this Spanish village is wonderful. No, you didn't. weren't going for that. You weren't going to fall for that. I've taken all season long to submit to your Italianness, and finally I have. Here we go then, map number three, with a Subaru already two maps to the good. Can they make it a third in a row very quickly and return themselves immediately to the World of Tanks Pro League? Looks like they're going to go for a four-man push here on the River Walkway along the 8 line and already sent Stenley in the Chaffee onto the edge of the Abbey. And they've spotted a T69 very early on. That's the Chaffee spotting that one. And are they going to be able to do anything about it? They've got these four Tier 8 tanks piling themselves away along the side of the river. Meanwhile, what are Woosa doing? Oh, Woosa Energy, they're going to meet them head on right now, right on the edge of the river. We're going to get a huge tank battle. They're exchanging shells left, right and center. Let's try and get down into the middle of this one. And it's going to be Woosa who lose the first one. Voodoo's picks up the first. They're then going to go into a little bit of reloading here, but no, not before Voodoo's goes down. Mirage replying back for the revenge tank kill. And two big shots back onto one of the Woosa players at the back. And I think he's going to go down if he stays where he is. So another graveyard of tanks this time by the picturesque side of the river. It's 2-1 overall.
So in the meantime, we have a small engagement going on in the base then. In the Super's base. One T69 pushed all the way through. And the I'm just confused. Oh, T2 Light and a T69 it was. The T2 Light will be killed pretty fast by the Chaffee, and now it's next. Now it's the T69 next. Oh man, I'm so confused. So much action going on at the moment.
Yeah, exactly right. There's a T69 versus the M24 right now, and that Chaffee is going to be blown up very shortly indeed because he can't win that battle. That's a one-sided battle as ever you'll see. And ooh, a little bit of a side swipe there onto Thelmo, and he's going to go down here in that artillery. And again, another little bit of a bash, and they're going to try and take him down at short range. He has taken a lot of damage here though. And Thelmo, I don't think he can get away with this somehow. Here we go. Turret spun all the way around. And again, backs away, takes a bit of space, gets the kill. And that gets rid of the artillery. And we're back to a 3-3 game.
That's right. The T69 did manage to survive and take down the artillery, but not without taking a lot of damage. 350 HP left. And that shouldn't be a big deal for the T69. Capture has started. So a lot of pressure now onto the final tank. Final tier 8 tank was. He is now. No. Oh God, yeah. I'm so confused with all the things going on.
Yeah, there's three gone down very quickly. The final one goes down. They've actually got one tier 8 tank remaining right now. They have destroyed the 69 and the Lorraine and the T1. So just the final tier 8 tank remaining at the moment. Asuba though have got. Oh my goodness.
He just dropped down into the river and killed himself.
Oh. Oh dear. Oh, that's sad. Oh, bless him. Bless him.
So,
that's a sad end to a sad game, frankly.
That's right.
I'm almost glad that game's over because it wasn't the game that we wanted it to be, and it wasn't the game it should have been either. I'm very disappointed with Woosa, I have to tell you. I don't think they'll care one iota what I think of them. But their attitude this evening has not been good. And I don't know whether we can talk about it or not. Maybe we'll talk about it in the start of the next game once we've had a discussion about it. But not good behaviour by them this evening. And I think they were very insulting to both Stephen and I and to Asuba as well. Not good attitude, not good manners either. Thankfully, though, the right team have won. Would it have been different on another day if they could have played on a different day? Who knows? We'll never know because today was the day they were supposed to play. Asuba have turned up. They weren't affected by it, and they've won 3-0. They will return to the World of Tanks Pro League in Season 2. And we have just one more game to go this evening, and we'll find out whether Alpha can also retain their place or whether they get replaced and we have a third new team in the World of Tanks Pro League in Season 2. Don't go too far away. We'll be right back with match number 2.